direction.
Service is found beginning at the bottom of page 1. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To us, Lord, we pray, the Spirit to think and do always those things that are right, that we who cannot exist without you may by you be enabled to live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The vision of Isaiah, son of Amos, which he saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem in the days of Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah. Hear the word of the Lord, you rulers of Sodom. Listen to the teaching of our God, you people of Gomorrah. What to me is a multitude of your sacrifice, says the Lord. I have had enough of burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts. I do not delight in the blood of bulls or the lambs or goats. When you come to appear before me, who asks this from your hand? Trample my courts no more. Bringing offerings is futile. Incense is an abomination to me. New moon and Sabbath and calling of convocation. I can't endure solemn assemblies with iniquity. Your new moons and your appointed festivals my soul hates. They have become a burden to me. I am weary of bearing them. When you stretch out your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Even though you make many prayers, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves, make yourselves clean. Remove the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do good. Seek justice. Rescue the oppressed. Defend the orphan. Plead for the widow. Come now, let us argue it out, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be like snow. Though they are red like crimson, they will come. They shall become like wool. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. But if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured by the sword. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read the portions of Psalm 50, which are printed in the bulletin, beginning on this side of the worship space for verse 1 and going to the south side for verse 2 and so on. The Lord, the God of gods, has spoken. He has called the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting.
Out of Zion, perfect against you, God reveals himself in glory.
Our God will come and will not keep silence. Before him there is a consuming flame,
and round about him a raging storm.
He calls the heavens and the earth from above to witness his judgment
of his people. Gather before me my loyal followers,
those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice.
Let the heavens declare
the righteousness of his cause, for God himself is judge.
Hear, O my people, and I will speak.
O Israel, I will bear witness against you, for I am your God.
Your God.
I
will
not accuse you of your sacrifices, your offerings, all things
before you. Consider this well,
you forget God, lest I rend you, and there be none to deliver you.
Whoever offers you the sacrifice, I shall be on high. Reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Now, faith is assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Indeed, by faith, our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what was seen was made from things that are not visible. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place he was received as an inheritance. He set out, not knowing where he was going. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised, in a foreign land, living in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to a city that has foundations, whose architect and builder is God. By faith, he received the power of procreation, even though he was too old, and Sarah herself was barren, because he considered him faithful with the promise. Therefore, from one person, this one as good as dead, descendants were born, as many as the stars of heaven, as innumerable grains of sand on the seashore. Always died in faith about having received the promises. From a distance they saw and greeted them. They confessed that they were strangers and foreigners on the earth. But people who speak in this way make it clear they are seeking the homeland. They have been thinking of the land that they had left behind. They have had the opportunity to return. As it is, they desire a better country. It is a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God. Indeed, he has prepared a city for them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Be dressed for action and have your lamp lit. Be like those who are waiting for their master to return from the wedding banquet, so that they may open the door for him as soon as he comes and knocks. Blessed are those whose slaves, whom are those slaves whom the master finds alert when he comes. Truly, I tell you, he will fasten his belt and have them sit down to eat and will come and serve them. If he comes during the middle of the night or near dawn and finds them so, blessed are those slaves. But know this, if the owner of the house had known at what hour the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. Now, Joanna, if I move over here, am I still on the...
Yes.
Oh, okay. How about over...
Oh. I got you.
You've done it 2 weeks in a row now. You're in a row.
When
I was coming down the aisle as we were processing in, I looked and I saw one person with this wonderful vista in front of them as they drove down the road. And I thought, I hope John's not watching the service, but Loretta is. So I guess that's how that went for. Voyagers are still out east, I think.
Yes, Harrisburg.
There, where are they?
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Oh, goodness. Hebrews. I'm really going to kind of ignore the gospel today and talk about that wonderful lesson that Dale read from Hebrews. Now, the author of Hebrews is an unknown author.
The best guesses are that it might have been Bartholomew, or maybe a later associate or a later disciple of Paul. One of the things we do know is it's the punchline to a really bad bit of biblical humor. The question is asked, who does Scripture say is responsible for making coffee? Told you it was bad. It's written to people who are giving up. So often these epistles that we take as great faith-filled documents are not written to congregations who are doing well. They're written to congregations who are struggling. The Corinthians were at each other tooth and nail. And we have that wonderful portion of Paul's letter to them about love. It's read at almost every wedding I've ever been to. But it's not because they were that loving. It's because they needed to hear what love looks like and feels like and is like. The Hebrews need to know about faith. They're leaving the church. They're leaving the faith. They have made sacrifices for their beliefs. They have endured suffering. And now they're forked. You know, like, stick a fork in me, I'm done. The message is, don't give up. Have faith. Trust. Jesus Christ is the one that you can place faith in. Jesus Christ equals faithfulness. Did you hear the rhythm of God's heartbeat in the lesson that we heard? By faith is a phrase used 5 times in 6 sentences. By faith, our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the words are prepared by the word of God. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised. By faith, he received power of procreation, even though he was too old. By faith. We also get an incredibly helpful definition of faith in the first few words, the first sentence of this lesson. Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. If you don't have much scripture memorized, after all your Episcopalians, Joanna had an experience at Fort recently that I'm going to share with you, at least a portion of what I remember, which is always a small bit of what's told. But she heard something at work, and she said, oh, that's from Isaiah. In fact, I think she gave chapter and verse.
Yes, I did.
And the person looked at her and, like, I thought you were an Episcopal Christian. She said, well, I'm going to a Bible study. And we're studying Isaiah. And I remember this one. It can happen. That definition of faith is so incredibly powerful. The assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Is that an accomplishment on our part when we have faith? Is it due to our efforts, our work? Or is it due to our openness and acceptance, receiving something life-giving and empowering because God is faithful? Jesus is faithful. By our baptisms, we are connected to Jesus, both in faith and in faithfulness. Whether we're baptized as an infant or an adult, as a believer or as a baby. We are given and receive Jesus at baptism. Romans 6:5 says, if we are baptized into Jesus' death, we will be united with him in a resurrection like his. So whether the trust that is faith comes easy to you, or if you're like the Hebrews, and it takes great exertion, and sometimes we find it flagging and failing, we all receive the same strong Jesus who carries us into a future that we cannot see. Let me offer an image. You're on an airplane trip. Some flyers are confident, others not so much. Either way, the passenger's job is to get on the plane. The only responsibility is to get on the plane, sit down, buckle up, and follow instructions, and we hope be kind to those around us. Whether you're relaxed or nervous, it's really not an issue in your safety. Is it? Does your nervousness cause the pilot to not fly as well as he or she was trained to do? I hope not. I guess not. I believe not. It's all about the pilot's capability. If there's turbulence, whether you're undaunted or manic, it's the pilot's training and abilities that get you through it. Safety is the same for all passengers. Confident travelers have a better experience. The heartbeat of Hebrews, by faith, by faith, by faith, by faith, by faith, is an encouragement to stick with the community of Christians and to stick with Jesus Christ. Trusting that living with willing hearts, open to the unknown future, God has prepared for us, like being a confident passenger. As Sarah and Abraham, as Isaac and Jacob did, we become inheritors of that future better than anything we can imagine or ask for. Jesus' faith, like the pilot's capabilities, makes the difference. Our faith in Jesus lets us do things we couldn't do otherwise. What Jesus did and does for us, and sometimes our tiny mustard seed sized faith that connects us to him, means we can hope, we can serve, we can enjoy, we can be confident. Look for it. Prepare for it. And do our part to live in it. True, we cannot see the future, but Jesus has made a future that awaits us, that forms us, and that can inform our present if we allow it. A life marked by love and meaning and possibility and peace beyond death. So the simple message of Hebrews is stick with Jesus. Stick with Jesus. And stick with the church. It's when we practice and see the faith that relies on God's promise and Jesus Christ's faithfulness, faith that stands on the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things seen. This faith reconciles marriage partners who may have suffered infidelity. This faith rebuilds relationships even after there has been heartbreak in them. It's the faith that carries people through incredible suffering and pain. The faith that helps people break addictions and ask for help. The faith that helps people care for children that others leave behind.
The faith that asks for forgiveness, faith that reconciles, faith that challenges and changes lives. Even a little bit of seeking and acknowledging God can lead to hope, joy, strength, and a future we cannot see, but of which we can be assured, of which we can become. Phillips Brooks, who wrote a number of hymns and was a wonderful preacher, said it this way: I beg you to live far-looking lives. Lift up your eyes and see the places afar off. You may not see all the way between, but keep your eyes forward still. The present cannot be known or done except by the future's interpretation and the future's inspiration. And no one can know the future rightly except as they know it in Him, who is the Lord of our lives. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. And how do we do it? By faith. By faith. By faith. By faith. By faith. As we face the cross of Christ, turn to page 6 in our bulletins. Let us say together the words of our faith.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We have been taught to pray by the Lord. So with one voice, we ask for us all, saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
To face the promise of life, the courage you give, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face the evil of life with the goodness you give, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face the death of life with the love you give, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face our aged with your unfailing mind, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face our youth with your unfailing heart, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face our poor with your unfailing hand, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face all war with loathing, as you do, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To face all peace with longing, as you do, we pray you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And here you may offer your own intercessions, be your allowed or in silence.
For Jay.
Amen.
For Bobby.
Amen.
For the Matias family.
Amen.
For Nicholas.
Amen.
For Christopher and Carly.
Amen.
Amen.
It is your way with life that we want, O Lord, that we ask of you. And you have offered it. It is a joy to live by you. May those who do not know this find it out through your presence to their world. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And even though it's not bolded, would you join with me in the prayer of the Good News Festival, which follows? Loving God,
author of life, in you we live and move and have our being. We ask that you revive us again in your mighty spirit as we prepare our hearts for the Good News Festival. Inspire us to reach out to those who do not know you and welcome them with open arms, without judgment, so that all may embrace your good news and answer your call and dance together with joy. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most
merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving and make good your vows the Most High.
Be filled by the Spirit of the Lord, Holy One is here. And now be before him now, shelter and if with no sin in time, we stand on holy ground, we still have Spirit of the Lord, the Holy One is here. We still are the glory of the Lord, shining all around. With holy fire, let's enter in his crown. Our hope lives inside, our faith can be applied.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. In your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. In this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray in song. Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast.
Hallelujah.
Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Oh,
Ourselves on page 12, let us pray the prayer after communion. Almighty and ever-living God,
we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
May Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing. Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever. Amen. Please be seated unless you have a birthday, a traveling prayer, an anniversary that you'd like prayers for. No one is rushing for. Oh, here comes someone. Oh, my gosh.
I'm trying to unmute. How do I...
This is the chair of our stewardship.
Okay, so the prayer for traveling, two-thirds of our family is traveling today together from New Year, so it's
sure. Absolutely. Okay. And Leanne?
I am traveling with one of my sisters from here to Scottsdale to meet up with the other sister for our annual sisters thing. And so the one's coming on a plane, the other two of us are driving. So just
and you're going to Scottsdale.
Oh, yeah, but we rented a house with a pool.
Okay.
We do this every year in the summer, someplace hot like that. So we're all over it.
Okay, great. See, I'm thinking Big Bear. Yeah.
No, but it's only, I think that it's going to be 100 in the life. Yeah, because we thought it's usually 110, 115, somewhere like that. Yeah.
You might, on your driving over there, you might go through Death Valley.
I've been there.
Oh, okay.
Your car wash.
Yeah, car wash. That's right. All right, let us pray. Gracious God, be with those who travel, those who are traveling to family, and those who are traveling from family. We ask that you would be with them every one of the steps of their journey, and make sure that they are safe and held in your loving embrace. May they share your love with those whom they encounter, receive your love from those they meet, and come back to those of us who love them here. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, I will tell you that the stewardship team met this week, had a very fruitful meeting, and so you will be beginning to see some things that are stewardship or pledge campaign related over the next couple of 3 months. We won't actually begin the pledge campaign in November, but we will be sharing information, and we'll be returning to our minutes for mission or 1 minute stewardship sermons beginning next week. So we hope that you all will gain something from the educational aspects that we offer, and that we will have a good, fruitful experience with that as well. I don't really have anything else for you. I'm pretty sure that Dale has something he wants to say. And Anita's not here today. So anybody else have anything to share? Marty? No? Okay. All right, Dale.
I would say that we're getting near the end of our our Bible study of Isaiah. It's been a very fruitful time, but I'm trying to think how to work this through. But it's Isaiah is a little like the generous, if you remember the parable of the generous employer who paid the same day's wages to the ones that started work early in the morning, the one that started in mid-morning, the one that started in the afternoon, and the one that came at the end of the day and worked for an hour. So the thing is that even though you may not have participated this whole time, there are enough nuggets of wisdom and spiritual gifts in Isaiah that if you come even to the last reading, you'll be rewarded your day's work. So thank you again. We look forward to seeing you. Yes. 7 o'clock.
Would you
really get the Tuesday evening? Get the Zoom connection from your region. See you then. Thank you.
I would be remiss in not mentioning, just so you all can plan for it. This is Jenny McBride's penultimate Sunday with us before she becomes a full-blown college woman. So you know, enjoy the naivete, the innocence, the loving nature that you see now, because she will become hardened by higher education. I know that.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you will travel to Idaho.
Yes.
Excellent.
Next Sunday is our last Sunday.
Yeah.
And then
excellent. Okay. Well, we sure will miss you. But we know that you'll Zoom in every Sunday morning because you'll be home and in your own bed early on Saturday nights. Of course. Don't say of course. That's a mixed message. Of course. All right, let's sing our closing hymn number 7, as printed on page 13 of the bulletin.
Christ is the Savior, Christ is the Christ. didn't expect it so soon. Well, I still need to come on. Oh. Thank you so much. You're dismissing. Lovely. I can put this on the spot.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.